Mrs. McVeigh, might I say you have never looked lovelier.
That young husband of yours is gonna go bananas when he sees you in your open casket debut.
Words cannot describe, Mrs. McVeigh, but beauty queen does come to mind.
Okay, who do we have next?
Mrs. Flowers! What a surprise! I had no idea you passed. Oh my stars! How in the world?
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have asked. That is your business. That is your business. Good news is, I can fix this. Don't you worry, I'll have you looking fabulous again. Hair, makeup, the works. And no one, well, no one that doesn't already know, and hon, I'll keep that hush hush, wink wink, will ever find out that you got stuck with a stiletto.
My word is my bond, and my bond is strong.
I got the good shit, girl.
Now, while we let that dry for a spell, I can work on your dupe.
The higher the hair, the closer to God. Yes, tease it to Jesus. Rats. I thought we were going to have a quiet evening. What is it?
Miss Butterfield, you have a visitor. I'm going to send her to the back, okay?
Sure. Como no estoy haciendo nada. My apologies, Mrs. Flowers. I'll try to get rid of whoever this is.
Bitch, can you fix me?
God damn it, Shirley.
I have a show tonight, and I can't cha-cha on one foot.
How did you... You know what? I don't want to know. Sit.
Oh, shit, sorry.
This can't keep happening every week.
I'm sorry, Vi. I like to party.
Hold still, bitch.
Oh, oh. Oh, yeah. What the fuck you got to do with that? You are my magic man. Oh, I love your work. Thank you, Queen. It's better than that time I had all that plastic surgery done. Eat it, Dr. Howard.
Oh. I'm gonna start making you pay me.
Oh, girl, please. You are better than Jesus, Mary.
I love you, hun, but you are one sloppy cunt.
Bitch, I'm just happy my pussy hasn't fallen off yet.
Well, that one would be your problem. Okay, bye now. I have actual work to do.
Love you, girl.
Please don't come back.
See you tonight.
No. Hi. No more visitors and or clients for the rest of the evening, please.
Yes, Miss Butterfield. I'm gonna take off for the night in.
No more disturbances, Mrs. Flowers. It should be peaceful for the rest of the night. Now, where were we? Oh, yes. Rats. ¿Quién carajo será?
Violet?
Yes, and you are?
Violet Butterfield?
In the flesh, who the fuck are you?
My name is, Morgan.
What you got there, sugar? I see. It'll cost you.
So, Mr. Marvin, you want to tell me how you lost your finger?
Well, I kind of did it to myself. My ring was stuck, so I tried to take it off with a pair of pliers.
Wedding ring? Hand, please.
Yeah, I was married 45 years.
I'm sorry.
So am I.
Your body must be pretty new. Still soft. How long ago did you die?
1 year this week, actually.
1 year? Well, you're a newborn baby. Is this your first injury?
Yeah, I tried to mend it myself, but nothing took. Anything I tried, my body rejected it. I don't know.
Let me guess. Glue? Staplers?
I tried sewing it on, but it just kept falling off. Stitches kept disappearing, and the staples too.
The joys of a postmortem injury.
I'm so thankful I found you.
Hold that. Let it ripen. Still talk to anyone from your original life? Friends? Family?
No. No one. My friends slowly disappeared over the years, but that was nothing to be lost. My parents, I don't talk to them either, fortunately.
Fortunately?
Yes, fortunately. My parents had a firm grip on me my entire life. And they knew it. It was like a high just to get their approval. Never wanted to disappoint them. When I was 14, they wanted me to join the basketball team. So I did. Let me tell you, I was terrible. Terrible at all sports, mind you. When I was in college, I wanted to major in the arts. Oh, how I love to draw. I would draw all over the walls if I could. But my parents wanted me to go to business school. Of course I did. And after that, I took over my father's business. Just like he wanted. Made good money too. That definitely kept the wife happy. She got to shop all the time, keep herself enveloped in the finest fashions. Honestly, I rather enjoyed gifting her those fabulous Chanel suits. You know, my parents introduced us.
Did you love her? Your wife?
Not like that, but I married her regardless. Couldn't tell you why, or why I let her go on for so damn long. Truth is, she didn't love me either. What was important to her was keeping the facade. She would never release me. That's why I was convinced that this was my only escape. And I had no perception of what would happen actually. But I didn't care anymore. I couldn't care anymore. It's the only way that she would ever let me go.
Till death do you part. I'm really sorry.
Don't be sorry, dear. I had a lovely death.
I'm not sorry about your death. I'm sorry about your life. But you're here now, Marvin.
Marvin. Ugh. I never did like Marvin.
Well, sugar pie, you can be whoever you want now. No facades here. Anything goes. Anyone you want to be. Finito.
You know, I can never be who I wanted to be. I always felt this pressure to be someone else. Every unspoken expectation. All I ever was just Marvin. Goddamn Marvin. And now, I can finally be the person that's been inside me. And no one's gonna take that away from me. Because it doesn't matter anymore. I can finally be that wonderful person.
Does this person have a name?
Yes. Barbara.
Suits you.
Ah. You have a gift.
More like a curse. Money, please.
Oh, worth all the nickels.
Pleasure. Please don't come back.
Well, hopefully, but I have a feeling we'll see each other again.
Not unless you take care of your body this time.
Well, you of all people know that Accidents do happen.
You take care of yourself, Barbara. She will be back.
Right, Mrs. Flowers? Now, where were we? Oh, yes.
Now, while we wait for that to dry, I've got a new lipstick I've been dying to try on you. Tangerine Delight. I bet it will look perfect on you. You won't even recognize yourself. There. Preciosa.
Do you have a problem with your skin falling off?
Oh, f***!
No need to call your death doctor. We'll come to you. Violet Butterfield.
Who are you?
Skin adhesive for those minor fixes in between appointments. Just a spritz or two and your skin is brand new. All new Violet Butterfield skin adhesive for the dead.
It's burning. Should it be burning?